Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate how you can send email alerts to processes using Process Builder in Salesforce. If you want to follow Salesforce training videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta on YouTube and you can follow my YouTube channel. So now coming onto the topic, here you can see I created one process so that this is not complete right now. I just selected the object contact. And this process will work when a record is created or edited. Then I created one criteria, that is check lead source. So condition is if lead source is equals to web, then this criteria will be true and this action will be performed. So here we need to choose an action, that is email alerts. So whenever we choose this option, email alerts, then an email will be sent automatically whenever you create or update your record if your criteria is true. So for email alert, first you need to create email templates. So I already created this email template for contact email alerts. So this is email template. This is the content of this email template. After creating email template, you need to create email alerts. So from quick find, you can search for email alerts and you can create email alerts. So here you can see I have created various email alerts. I'm opening this one. So this email alert is having this email template attached and recipient will be the email field that is available on the record, right? So now I'm going to use this email alert in this process. So name is send email. And email alert's name is email alert to contacts. So I'm typing this one, email alert to contacts. So I chose this email alert and I'm clicking on save. So this way I created immediate action as email alert. So this email will be sent automatically whenever I create record or whenever I update any record. Now I'm clicking on activate. So this process is activated right now. Now I'm moving to contact. I'm creating new contact. So let's say name is test process one. I have to fill this because email will be sent to this email ID. So email ID is sanjaygupta.techschool@gmail.com. I'm choosing lead source as web and clicking on save. So a record is created. You can see the details, email and lead source both are available. And if I check my mailbox, you will see an email is available here that is through process that we created. So whenever I'm creating this contact record, an email is triggered. Now I'm going to create one more contact record. And this time I am just putting my email ID. So lead source is blank right now. So it is giving duplicate warning. So I'm changing its name, clicking on save. So right now you can see email field is filled, but lead source is blank. And if we see our mail, so no mail is triggered right now. Now I'm going to update this. So lead source will be web, clicking on save. So I updated this contact record and now you will see one email will be available here. So yeah, here it is. So whenever I update contact record, and if the criteria matches, that is available in the process builder. So if this criteria matches, then automatically this immediate action will be performed, right? Now let's update any other field, let's say label. So I'm updating this one as secondary. I'm clicking on save. So this time I updated label field. and email and lead source are as it is. Let's see email box. So here you can see one email is again available. So this is wrong. If I update any other field except lead source, this email should not be triggered, right? So if you don't want to execute your criteria whenever you update any other field, so here you will see this option. So do you want to execute the action only when specified changes are made to the record? So right now it is unchecked. So you need to clone your process. And you need to click on this advanced option and you need to check this and read this carefully. So here you can read this. When you select yes, the actions are executed only if the record meets the criteria now, but the values that the record had immediately before it was saved didn't meet criteria. This means that these actions won't be executed when irrelevant changes are made. So right now I am changing label field that is not relevant to the criteria that is available in the process. So if you want to execute your process whenever this lead source changes to web, so you need to check this checkbox as yes. So whenever on your record this lead source value will be web, then only your process will be executed. So whenever you are changing your lead source field to web, then only this criteria will be matching and this action will be performed. If you change any other field on that record, then this process will not be executed because you are not changing lead source field, right? So if you want to execute the action only when specified changes are made to the record, so you need to check this checkbox as true. Click on save. Now activate this, right? Let's create one more record so that we can test it again. So I'm going to put email now I'm going to update this record. So let's first check the email box. It is not having any email. Now I'm moving to update this lead source. So right now I'm updating this and our criteria will match. So process builder will work and it will trigger an email. So here it is. It is sending an email. Now if I update any other field, so I'm not changing lead source field, I'm changing label field, right? So because of that checkbox that we set as true, that says if you change a particular field that is the part of evaluation criteria, then only your action will be performed. Right now I'm changing label field that is not part of that criteria. So that process will not trigger and we will not receive any email. Right? So unnecessary, if you don't want to execute your process, then you can choose this advanced option as true so that if you made specified changes, then only your process will be fired and unnecessary actions will not be performed. So I hope you understood the requirement of this checkbox and how to send email alerts through processes using Process Builder in Salesforce. If you want to watch more Salesforce training videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta on YouTube and you can follow my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching this video.